Yona, and thank you for coming out here and joining us for this event. And to give you a little bit of history about myself, I am a registered nurse, and I have a PhD in holistic nursing and a master's in nutrition. So my emphasis is on nutrition, and I'm also an herbologist. And I teach about the medicinal qualities of food, to go back to the way nature intended and the way we were supposed to be eating. So I focus on teaching people and having people educate themselves so that when they're eating, they can really enjoy and appreciate the food that they're eating and the medicinal qualities of food. So some of those examples are with ginger. And people know ginger is anti-inflammatory. So if you can try to incorporate that in your food, in your recipes and things that you're eating, or you can have ginger tea, or you could just have ginger raw. And also garlic is anti-inflammatory, and it's also antiviral. So if you think that you're feeling like you're getting a cold or something, all the time you can eat raw garlic, and it really helps to work as an antiviral. So it's very important that today, I think with everybody's schedule and everybody's in a hurry and they're trying to just make something really fast, that actually it's simple and it's going back to the way nature intended. So it's not complicated and it's not difficult to eat this way. I have a Facebook page that if you would like, you could like my Facebook page, which is it's just my name, yona.info. And also do a newsletter every month that's free, and you can sign up for that on my website. It's about halfway down on the first page, and that is monthly, and I have the medicinal qualities of herbs, and then I do recipes, and then I do sometimes some spiritual stuff, because I also work on teaching everybody about whole body, to really work on not just your eating, but also your spiritual issues and your being physically active and exercising and eating healthy. So it's a combination of whole body. It's just not one thing. And then I also use herbs medicinally. And some of these herbs, for example, are echinacea, which some of you may know about, which helps if you feel like you're getting a cold because it boosts up your immunity. And then lavender, which is calming, and you can drink lavender tea to try to go to sleep and calm yourself down. So all of these things, if you can simplify your kitchen and just have your kitchen be really natural remedies, a lot of times it's very, it makes you focus, and it just makes you feel better, and it makes you be proactive with your own health. If you can do things preventative, and to try to prevent things from occurring. So I do eat a lot of raw foods, but I also eat cooked foods. And I eat a lot of soups that I cook, and I'll do quinoa, which is cooked, and some brown rice, and I'll do sprouted breads. So I always try to teach people, if you're going to eat stuff, you should try to eat sprouted food. So if you're going to eat bread and you want to eat bread and you don't have the problems with gluten or any of those issues, you should eat sprouted bread. And there's a couple of Ezekiel Food for Life bread, and also Alvarado makes sprouted bread, and they're just the way nature intended. They just take the grains, they sprout them, and then they use them to make the breads out of them. So it's going away from eating processed food that's white bread that's stripped of all its minerals and vitamins. With the sprouted, it retains all its minerals and vitamins in it. So those are things that you can think about when you're trying to transition. I teach people about being plant-based and eating vegan. I always say I don't call myself a vegan because I eat out, and I don't know if somebody else is preparing the food, and I don't know what's exactly in the food, but I asked for it to be vegan or plant-based, but something slips in there or whatever it is, I don't really know, and I do eat out. So I just don't say that I'm a classified, but at home I don't have any animal products, and I do eat vegan at home, and I eat plant-based at home. So I can't control somebody else's kitchen, and I can't control somebody else's cooking, but when I'm eating at home, that's what I do. And if I eat out, even if I eat at a buffet and it has different meat dishes or fish dishes or whatever, I don't eat them. I eat the lettuces, and I eat, and I look at the ingredients, and I eat the vegan stuff. So there is a benefit to eating raw foods. I don't recommend being 100% raw. I don't think anybody does do that. You can't eat certain foods when they're raw, so it just doesn't make any sense. But if you predominantly eat more salads and fruits and vegetables and then supplement it with other foods, it does make you feel different and you feel healthier. So, trying to think if there's salads, fruits, vegetables, quinoa, brown rice, and then sprouted breads, and then
beans,
yeah, a lung beans. And mung beans, you know, you can sprout the mung beans, you can sprout a lot of the beans. And you have to soak the beans to cook them, soak them overnight, and then you cook them the next day and stuff. So, this is a recipe that I make at home, and what I do a lot of times is I throw it on top of a salad, or I put it on some toast or some flax crackers. I don't know if anybody knows what flax crackers are. That is flax seeds that are soaked, and then they're mixed with celery, carrots, and soy sauce and different and onion, and then it's dehydrated, and they make crackers out of them. So you can get them. Glazer Farms makes really good flax crackers, and they have a farmer's market on Saturday, which is wonderful, and they have a raw food buffet, and they also have a lot of produce there, and they have a lot of nut pâtés. It's for the people that are working and don't have time to make some of these things, but you can buy them, and they have nut pâtés and juices and all kinds of stuff. So, but they do sell flax crackers, and then you can also get them. I'm not sure if Whole Foods has them, if anybody's seen them. You have? Okay. I order them through my company, through one of the companies that I order from, and I get flax crackers from them too, and they're really good. So you can put the nut pâtés on those, you can put them on sprouted bread, you can throw them on quinoa, and then it makes it have more protein. And I'm trying to think of what else. Throw in brown rice, whatever. But this is raw, so it's not cooked. And what I did was I doubled the recipe. You have the recipe on a piece of paper, but I doubled it because I didn't know how many people were going to be here, and I didn't want to, God forbid, I wouldn't have enough food to give everybody to sample it. So I did double it, and it's, I'm going to tell you, the doubling recipe, is that what you want me to do? Or just, I can tell you exactly what I have here. So everything is just doubling it if you want to do that and make more. But if you're making it at home, don't double it. Because I think if you let it sit in the fridge for just too long, it's not going to taste as good, and it might start fermenting. It probably wouldn't be bad for you to eat it, but it's not as fresh. So you want to get through this. If you do the single recipe, you want to get through it 3 to 4 or 5 days the max with the pâté. So I took walnuts and I soaked them for 2 to 4 hours in filtered water. And then I drained the water. And I did all the prep at home because it would have taken me a long time because it took hours to do this. And so I just prepped everything before I came here with a food processor. And that's something that I highly recommend. You can get a food processor for $50. It doesn't have to be a $500 food processor. But I would recommend, if you're transitioning to eating plant-based and you want to eat more raw foods, to invest in buying a food processor. It's a very good investment. And because you want to be chopping up all this stuff, and you can't really chop these things up as fine as you can to make the pâté the way you need to make it. So after I soaked and drained the walnuts, I put them in the food processor and I ground them up fine, very fine, but not enough to be like a nut butter, like not a walnut butter or a peanut butter. It's not that fine, so you do have to keep an eye on it. And that is in this container. I don't know if, can everybody see this? You see it okay?
Yeah.
Okay, so it is, if you look, okay, it's ground, so you have to be careful when you do the food processor that you're not making a nut butter, okay? So I'm gonna put that in here.
Can you use a Vitamix?
You know, I have a Vitamix, but I wouldn't use it for this. Same thing. You know, I'm 60, and I have been cooking and making food for probably 30 years more. And I think that the Vitamix, I love Vitamix, I have a Vitamix, and it serves its purpose, but I wouldn't use it for that, I think, because it might be a little bit harder to, the bowl is bigger on a food processor, and then the blade is in there, and it's going around, and you can just pause it and stop it, whereas the Vitamix is like a cylinder. And so I just think that it would be really hard because maybe you wouldn't get it all or whatever it is. I don't know. Okay, so I have the walnuts in here. And I will tell you that it is best. And you know how soup is always better the next day and then the second day? Because the herbs that you put in there and the fresh herbs and stuff are sitting, and it just comes out and every day you go, oh my God, this soup just tastes even better the next day. So I love stuff like that. So I'm gonna put this together for you now. I'm not sure it will taste much better tomorrow, but it may not be able to get all the flavors incorporated in it. So it's gonna taste probably not as flavorful, I'm gonna say, all right? And then next, I did the celery. And instead of one stalk, I did two stalks for this recipe. And that's what I got. And I did grind that up in the food processor also. So if you can all see what it looks like, all right, it's not like mush. It's still got some crunch to it, but it doesn't have big pieces in it. It's if you just took a really sharp knife and just chop, 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 chop. That's kind of the consistency of it. So I'm going to add the celery. Okay. And then next is the carrots. And the recipe calls for two carrots. And this is, what I did was I got these carrots, and I'm not kidding you, I've never seen carrots this big. They were huge. And to me, I just got two very large carrots, which were like four carrots. So I would call this four carrots in here. And if you look and see.
They're cheering for you. Isn't that amazing?
Thank you, Jeff. If you can see the consistency of it, if anybody wants to come up here and look, you're welcome to come up here also and look at it if you want to get close. So it's not mush, it's just pieces of it, but small enough that they're tiny little pieces. So I'm going to put the carrots in here. And the carrots are nice because it gives them, especially if you get good carrots, there aren't such thing as bad carrots and good carrots. And if you get bitter carrots, it can really make a difference in a raw dish because it's going to make it bitter. But if you get really sweet carrots, and I will tell you, I feel like a carrot connoisseur, but my favorite carrots are the Bunny Love. I don't know if anybody knows what they are. And I know Glazer has them, but they don't have them at Whole Foods. They have Whole Foods carrots, but I really like Bunny Love because they're just so sweet, and they really make a big difference in the flavor of them. Okay, so I have all this stuff in here, and now I'm just going to mix it up a little bit. Okay. And then it is one tomato, and this is two tomatoes. It's double the recipe. So these I chopped by hand with a good sharp knife, and I just chopped them into small pieces. I don't put the tomatoes in the food processor because I might get tomato sauce, probably. Okay, mixing that up. And then the recipe calls for a half a red pepper. And for today, I used a whole red pepper, and I chopped that by hand with a good sharp knife also. Now remember, it is labor intensive, and it is a lot of work. But you're talking about making this and having this for 4 or 5 days. So that's like a lot of food for 4 or 5 days. But the initial time, I do these cooking marathons. I get in the kitchen and I make something like 6 hours. I make a whole bunch of stuff, but then I have food for a couple days. And I used to just a lot of times do fresh every day, whatever. But in realizing too that the flavors just intensify and get better as the food sits. And the other thing is, it's not animal based, so it doesn't go bad. Like if you're making animal based food and you have to eat it in a day or two, you don't have to do that with plant based food. I mean, I will tell you, some things can last for 5 to 7 days in the fridge if you have it, and I wouldn't be afraid to eat it. And what's the worst thing? You too? What's the worst thing is, you know, maybe it grows mold, but I haven't seen that. So, growing mold on it. I haven't seen that in any of the food that I've made. So, I wouldn't even think twice about it. If soup is sitting in the fridge for 4 or 5 days, I would eat it. Because I never have an issue with anything growing mold. But if you do animal products, you know, mold grows on cheese, chicken, beef, all those things. You have to eat them, and you have to cook them right away. Because, and fish, they go bad.
Mushrooms are very dangerous.
Mushrooms?
You let that sit.
Really?
You get botulism.
Okay, half a red pepper. The next thing is, I'm going to put this in there. Is everybody okay with raw red onions?
Okay?
Because they're yummy in here. So I did 1/8 cup. So it's 2 of those. And I chopped those also by hand and got some good tears out of this one because this one was very strong. I was like, oh my goodness, when I was chopping this. Okay, we're going to mix that up. And then you can mince or you can chop the garlic. I chopped it, didn't mince it. And that's here, and I chopped it really, really small. So if any of you got a chunk of it, you're not going to be like, okay. Smells good. Can you smell it?
Right now. Yeah.
Okay. That's the garlic. Okay. Does anybody know what the herb is that's dried herbs de Provence? Has anybody ever used
lavender,
that?
Yeah. From France. It's lavender.
I should have brought a list of it.
Thyme.
Rosemary. It's my favorite, absolutely my favorite. I do that in a lot of my soups.
Oregano.
What I do is I use that as a base, and then I have a herb garden with rosemary and sage and oregano, and then I pick an herb from there, sometimes rosemary, and I take it from the garden, and I chop it up, and I put that in my soup, and then I put a bay leaf, and it's amazing. Amazing. I like my cooking, but I always say when I make a soup, I said, oh my God, this is like the best soup. And then the next one I go, this is like the best soup. And of course, my mother's sitting there in the back, and I cook for her, and she may be biased because I'm her daughter, but you can ask her if she likes my cooking. She always tells me, oh, this is so good. This is so good. Okay, I'm going to make sure that this gets mixed up really well. So the herb that I'm going to be using, even though it's dried and it is raw, I'm going to be putting the herbs in here, and it's herbs of Provence. So good. It really smells good. So it's a combination. I don't know how many of, like six or seven, I should have brought the what it has in it. But, and I'm going to put that in there, and it's 2 teaspoons. Mixing that up. And then also a handful of chopped parsley. So I did this by hand too. And that is really good when you're eating the garlic because it takes bad breath away, just so you know. Okay? So if you combine raw parsley with the garlic, it'll help with a strong smell on your breath from that. And parsley is also a diuretic. So it's really, and the greens, the chlorophyll in it is really, really good for you. So I'm going to put that, it's about 2 handfuls of parsley. The onions are like.
The garlic too.
I can smell it. And most of the ingredients are organic. On my recipes and when I post on my blogs and everything, I don't put organic because I don't want people personally to feel that they have to buy organic to make these ingredients. But I, for 30 years or more, I've been trying to buy organic, and I support the organic industry, and I do eat organic foods if I can. I can't get everything in organic. But when I can, I do. And yes, it's more expensive, but I support their philosophy and what they're doing, and I believe in it. And I'm like a real dedicated person when it comes to that. Okay. And then this is Himalayan sea salt, the real stuff. Pink. So if you can get this for your kitchen, yes, it is expensive, and yes, it comes in rocks, you know, the rock stuff, but you have to go and purchase a grinder, and then you put that in the grinder, and you grind it up fresh when you're cooking. And it's much better than regular salt, and it has a lot of the minerals and vitamins in it, and it's just much healthier for you to have. And it doesn't have the same sodium content that regular salt does. It's less. So it's actually healthier for you to eat it. So I'm going to put in a teaspoon of that.
What about the pre-ground Himalayan salt that you can buy?
You know, that's probably fine, but I don't know. I just try to do everything. I'm not going to say old-fashioned, but as natural as possible. Doing stuff. But it's real interesting because, you know, years ago, I think, I don't remember if it was 15 or 20 years ago, the big thing with cut your salt, all the doctors were saying you got to get, you know, don't eat so much salt, it's bad for you. And I did this experiment because I'm always like researching and doing experiments, and I got off of salt pretty much. Now, celery has salt in it naturally. You know, food has salt in it anyhow. Naturally, a lot of foods, but I didn't take any extra added salt, and I just wanted to see, and I actually didn't feel good, and I missed the salt. So I believe that you have to have some salt in your food. You just, it's something that we need, and to just not have any at all, I don't think is good for you. That's my opinion. I felt so much better when I started adding it. And actually, my blood pressure was really low. It was like 80 over 60. If anybody knows what normal blood pressure is, it's like 120 over 80. My blood pressure was like 80 over 60. And my blood pressure runs low normally, but it was really low. And so I just felt like I just didn't. And the other thing is I was drinking a lot of water, too. Because when you have balance of sodium with water, it retains the water and you don't need to drink as much water. But I was drinking and drinking and drinking. So I just did it and I didn't feel good when I did that. So, and even as an herbalist, it took me 10 years to get my herbology degree. I had to try all the herbs. So I had to try all the herbs and write about how they made me feel. And that was not fun because some of them I didn't like and I didn't like how they made me feel. If anybody knows what valerium is, do you know what valerium is?
Yeah, if you see.
Yeah, I did not feel good when I took that. And I had to take it to just see how it made me feel, because if I'm going to recommend them to a patient or client, I have to know what it does. And I have to know how it makes me feel. Now, you tell me what doctors, I'm not trying to bash doctors because we need doctors for certain situations, but what doctors take all those pharmaceuticals that they prescribe, which is, don't get me started on that. Anyhow, they don't take them. They don't take them before they give them to you, but as an herbalist, you're supposed to be experimenting and taking the herbs before you give them to somebody. So then if they say, well, I have this situation or I have this reaction to it, you can understand because you've taken it before. And there's much less side effects from herbal formulas. They do have some side effects than there is from pharmaceuticals. So I also work with people to try to get them off. If any of you have you seen What the Health and Forks Over Knives, I work really hard with people trying to get them off of pharmaceuticals. And I try to get them into some food that replaces the pharmaceutical or some herb that doesn't have the side effects of a pharmaceutical. So I do believe that, and I do believe I am a nurse, and I am educated as a nurse, and so we need medicine and we need doctors for, God forbid, if there's an emergency situation and you have something, you know, you have to go on medications for whatever reason. But I don't think they were intended long-term. They're intended for emergency situations and short-term, and then you're supposed to get off of them. They're not intended for you to be on them years and years and years. That's not what they're meant for. So, hopefully by mixing this a little bit, it'll incorporate all the flavors. And you do, you know, standing in the kitchen, if anybody ever stands in the kitchen, I don't know if anybody likes to cook and stand in the kitchen, but when you're standing in the kitchen for 6 hours and you're kneading bread or you're mixing or you're stirring or you're chopping, I feel like I got like this amazing workout. And my daughter is almost 30 and she used to say to me, wait a minute, you have bigger biceps than me and I work out. And she said, how come you have these big biceps? And I go, I don't work out. I don't do, you know, weights or any of that other stuff. And I think it's from, look at me. How long have I been standing here doing this? And this is not, trust me, this is thick and it's not easy to mix. Okay, so I am like, you know, moving my arm and getting some exercise with it. Estella knows because she's a cook. And you get tired. After you're standing in the kitchen for 6 hours, your legs are tired, you know, your back's tired, your arms are tired, whatever. Okay.
It's ready?
It's ready. So what I want to do is what I thought, we could have everybody come up and then get some, and then whatever is left, we'll just put out. But I just want to be sure that everybody gets some of it.
Bring your plate, please, so you can sample.
Question, can you suck any of the nuts for the walnuts?
Pardon?
Have you ever sucked enough of the nut for the walnuts?
Actually, I make the same thing, I'm glad you asked that, with almonds, and you can make it with sunflower seeds.
But not cashews. Cashews too soft.
You know, the cashews I use to make, you know those cheesecakes?
Yeah.
I make the raw cheesecakes with that. That's what I use that for. You're right, it just kind of has a interesting taste after they're soaked, and then if you put sweetener in it and different things, it gives it a good flavor like a cheesecake, the lemon, you know, the skin of the lemon and different things, and then the lemon juice. But I wouldn't use it in this personally. I don't know. What do you, Estella, what do you think? Cashews? I wouldn't do it. I would do, and sunflower seeds are really good for you, and they have a lot of protein in them. So remember, this is protein. So when people say, where do you get your protein from? You get your protein from nuts and seeds and beans and grains that are sprouted have a lot of protein. Those breads that I told you about, they have 4 to 8 grams of protein per slice. Okay, that's a lot.
So can you please, if you want to sample, bring your plate and sample, please.
On behalf of EarthSave, we want to thank Yona for delivering the goods. They're very good, I'm sure. And the goods, the information. And so this is our apron. It says, saving the world one bite at a time. And that's the whole vegan message in a bite.
I'm so excited. Thank you. Green, one of my favorite colors. Thank you so much.
Thanks to Estella.
I need a good apron. Slice, thank you. This is wonderful. I appreciate it. And thank you for having me here. I really appreciate it.
Okay,
I did put cards on the table, and if y'all want to sign up for my newsletter, that's free every month. And if you send me emails, I will answer them myself. If you have any questions about your health issues and any suggestions that you have, you can send them to me and I'll answer them.
I don't see
any. Pardon?
You need to get the card.
Here. I'll put some on the table. And
so come on up.
Come on up, please.
Yep. Oh, and I do have a book with me for sale if anybody's interested, and I do have it on Amazon, but I'm selling it here today for $20, and it's a recipe book with about 25 pages of colored photos that have a lot of information in them, and I'll sign it for you if anybody's interested. It's right over here.
And what's the title of the recipe book?
$20.
Come and get one of Yona's books. Beautiful little package.
It says no animal products. What do I eat? Because everybody always asks me when I say I don't eat animal products, they say, what do you eat? So here I did a book telling them what we eat.
You need your own plate.
Nice picture. My daughter took that. She's a stocking. You ready to go here with this?